The human eye is a complex organ essential for vision, allowing us to perceive light and transmit images to the brain. At the end of a tiring day, before going to bed, I sit in front of my aquarium and enjoy the lives I can see with my own eyes. In this 8-month-old freshwater ecosystem, I can see various plants and creatures. They all live together in harmony. However, there are different organisms in the ecosystem that the eye cannot see in detail. These organisms form the foundation of the ecosystem and can be found in almost every body of water. I need more than just my eyes to closely examine these organisms. A microscope will easily reveal details that we cannot see with the naked eye. And this way, we will get to know the ecosystem more closely. Welcome to Peace of Nature. The microscope came in a nice case. With its rechargeable and wireless functionality, I'll be taking it with me on my nature trips. It has everything I need inside, so I don't need to purchase anything extra. The microscope has video and photo capturing features, and I can transfer the videos to my phone using the memory card. I can connect it wirelessly to the modem and stream the display to my phone and TV through its mobile app. I really like these features. A few samples come out of the package. I chose the cockroach leg. For someone like me who hasn't used a microscope much before, it's very easy to learn and use. I also like the screen quality. I want to thank Opqpq for sending me their Pro Wireless Video Microscope. I'm sharing a discount code with you. You can save on your purchase of a microscope. I've left the product link in the description. Let's explore the depths of the ecosystem. There is a monster on the leaf that is hard to see. It's a hydra. In fact, I see two of them side by side. Because they are strongly attached to the leaf, I might tear them apart while removing them, which would cause them to regenerate from the pieces. Therefore, I decided to cut the leaf. Hydra is a genus of small freshwater organisms that are part of the phylum Cnidaria. They are known for their simple tubular bodies, radial symmetry, and the presence of tentacles around their mouth. Hydras have remarkable regenerative abilities and can regenerate their entire body from even a small piece of tissue. They feed on small aquatic organisms and are often used in scientific research due to their regenerative properties. Interestingly, hydras are often considered to be biologically immortal under laboratory conditions, meaning they do not show signs of aging and can potentially live indefinitely if not affected by disease or predation. In their natural habitats, hydras play a role in the food web as both predators of small aquatic organisms and as prey for larger animals. Let's examine Daphnia, which are somewhat larger than hydra. They are my favorites at the moment. Daphnia, commonly known as water fleas, are small, transparent, freshwater zooplankton. Daphnia are small, transparent organisms. Their bodies are typically divided into two main parts, protected by an outer shell. Most Daphnia species are too small to be seen easily, though their size can vary depending on the species. Daphnia feed on phytoplankton and other tiny microscopic organisms. They are often filter feeders, meaning they collect food by filtering water. They reproduce both asexually and sexually. Asexual reproduction usually occurs under favorable conditions, while sexual reproduction often happens during environmental stress or changes. They live in freshwater environments like ponds, lakes, rivers, and other stagnant water bodies. Daphnia play an important role in aquatic ecosystems by consuming phytoplankton and serving as a food source for many fish species. They are important model organisms in biological and ecological research because they are sensitive to environmental changes and have rapid reproductive rates, making them useful for studying genetic and environmental effects. There are black, millimeter-sized specks among the algae. Let's see what they are. Their name is Ostracoda. Ostracods have a head, thorax, and abdomen, but their body is mostly enclosed within the bivalve shell. They possess antennae and mandibles for locomotion and feeding. Their eyes, which may be simple or compound, are often located on the head. Ostracods move using their antennae. The antennae are often long and used for swimming in the water column or crawling on surfaces. Ostracods are often used as bioindicators because their presence, absence, or abundance can indicate changes in environmental conditions such as water quality, salinity, and habitat disturbances. Ostracod fossils are abundant and diverse, providing insights into past climates, ocean conditions, and evolutionary history. Their hard shells fossilize well, making them useful for reconstructing ancient environments. They are studied for their role in sedimentology, paleontology, and environmental science. They help researchers understand historical changes in ecosystems and contribute to the study of ancient climates and marine environments. I'm curious about what we will find on the surface of the water with biofilm. Here, we have rotifer and ostracod side by side. As you can see, the ostracod seems to be holding something with its antennae that I can't identify, and it seems to be feeding on it. Isn't that interesting? The organism you see here is called a rotifer. They have a complex, segmented body with a head, trunk, and tail. Their most distinctive feature is the corona, a crown of ciliated cells at the head end that they use for feeding and locomotion. Rotifers use their ciliated corona to create a vortex of water, which helps them capture and ingest tiny particles such as algae, bacteria, and protozoa. Some rotifers can enter a state of cryptobiosis, where they become highly resistant to desiccation, extreme temperatures, and other harsh conditions. In this state, they can survive until conditions improve. There are hundreds of beneficial tiny organisms in aquarium water, each with its own role. Constantly intervening and making unnecessary water changes can harm these organisms. Therefore, please avoid unnecessary and excessive water changes. After following certain basic rules, the ecosystem we establish becomes self-sufficient and offers us unique views. I would be very happy if you subscribe to my channel. As always, thank you so much for your support. Peace and love.